Look at all this solar. This is what powered our stay here last night. Isn't this cool?
Well, I'm so lucky to be here with my friend Pratik, who invited us out to Schaumburg, Illinois to stay at his wonderful hotel. And what's so wonderful about his hotel, on top of the amazing staff you have, the amazing amenities, is the fact that your hotel is solar powered,
yeah.
Or at least partially solar powered. And we were just up, you're seeing right now, footage of the roof of one of your hotels, just covered wall to wall in solar panels.
Yeah.
Tell me how you got the idea for that. When did this happen?
So we always want to be very environmentally conscious and community focused when we're at our properties and developing properties. So I think that's something that we've always focused on. We wanted to actually have solar panels from day one. It took a little bit of while with the village and kind of getting things cleared with state incentives. But once it was up there, we're excited to have it out there, and it's producing.
Now, so you've had them up there since the beginning of the summer,
yeah.
Sounds like. And so you don't have a ton of data.
Sure.
But how much of the hotel do you think is being powered by solar right now? Roughly?
Right now, I would say roughly in the summertime, we're probably doing roughly 55 to 60% of the total production.
That's incredible to me, because I kind of pictured you were going to have some little solar array somewhere and it was just done for PR or something like that. But
sure.
This is like legit solar. Like, if you don't have a solar system, it might be hard to picture what that means. But to give you some idea, like on my roof back in Massachusetts, I've got a 9K system.
Sure.
And we're talking, just on one building here, 10 times that,
yeah.
In solar panels. Now, talk to me about your guests. How do you make it so that a guest is saving energy when that's probably not the first thing on their mind?
You know, we've implemented certain things inside the rooms that kind of conserve energy. We always look for energy efficiency products. We've got LED light bulbs in basically every single outlet you can think of. And we're constantly just trying to refine ways of making sure that the production that the staff uses as well is reduced. And obviously solar is a big part of that.
Now, I've seen in a lot of hotels that there are beginning to be more and more motion sensors.
Yeah.
But all those things are expensive, right? Because you have to decide whether to go to that new system. How do you decide when something, some new technology is worth doing on a massive scale?
You know, we would love to do a lot more innovative things at our hotels. Unfortunately, we run into regulation, whether it's from the city or the state, that kind of blocks that. There are progressive cities and states that kind of let you do a little bit more.
So basically municipal and state governments are kind of almost in your way sometimes.
Sometimes. But they can also be beneficial depending on where you're at and who you're talking with.
Okay, so yeah. It really depends on different, because you see many different parts of the country because you have different locations. It must
sure.
be interesting to see that some are more progressive than others.
Correct. It's just finding the right environment is key.
Now, when a city is more progressive,
yeah.
Does it make your job easier to go to, you know, adding new technologies?
Definitely.
I feel like a lot of the codes we have are like, it's got to be a light switch when you enter the room or something like that. And it's like, okay, but why? And they can never seem to answer that question. It's like, well, it's because it's the way it always was.
Exactly. I mean, I was in a hotel in Berlin a couple of years ago, and the entire hallway would shut off when there was nobody in there. As soon as you got out of the elevator, everything kicked on. There was safety and security in that, but it's also energy efficiency in that. Why do you need to have the
right.
entire hallway lit up when no one's in it? In your house, you don't leave the hallway lights on when you're not in a room, right. when the hallway.
Right. But I assume that many inspectors in the U.S. and many municipalities are like, no, you've got to have it lit all the time, 24/7.
Yeah, I mean, that's part of safety code, and I think that just needs to evolve over time. We're in a different age where, you know, you can still be safe and secure, but be energy efficient.
Right, I mean, the technology is there for that. I feel like if you're watching, if you're a viewer out there who's, you know, at a municipal level or a state level, like, look into this, because it's really, we need to do that.
Definitely.
Think about all those hallways in the world that are being lit as we speak for no reason.
Sure.
And that's a huge waste of
corporate
resources.
Offices. You look at a tower out in the city anywhere, and I'm sure all the hallways are lit in there, and there's probably only cleaning staff in a few offices at a particular time overnight.
Mm-hmm.
So think about that. It's kind of just talking with your state, local representatives and kind of saying, hey, this is something we want to push.
Now, going back to the solar, so many people I talk to, they're just like, well, it's not efficient enough yet, or I don't know, it doesn't sound like a good plan. There's never like a concrete reason, but it just sounds like basically they haven't seen it enough. And
sure.
what excites me about showing off your properties is you're a business person, you're not doing this for charity, you're doing this to make a living, and this makes financial sense and it makes environmental sense.
It does.
What kind of financial sense is it making for you?
I think the payoff period for us will be roughly 2 to 3 years.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So many people have a number of like 20 or 30 years. I've heard so many people say, I'm not going to do it because I'm kind of older and it's never going to pay off. And I'm like, are you going to die tomorrow? It does pay off really quickly.
Yeah. You also have to think about beyond saving money and trying to be nice and environmentally conscious. It also is a benefit to the guests, right? Like if you were to install carports, for example, and we're in a northern climate, those would have been definitely beneficial for, November, December to March, because now you're parking underneath the carport and you don't have your car covered in snow while it's producing electricity for the hotel.
But you don't have that at the moment, and that's not because you don't want to have it. It's because the city isn't quite ready or quite there yet, probably.
They're not there yet. I think we're working with them, and they've indicated that they're more than willing to consider
go there.
It. Yeah.
Okay. So, I mean, that's good. That's something that I feel like right now when people drive by your property, they don't know you have solar. When you have solar carports, I think that's going to attract more attention. People are going to be like, wait, what's this going on here?
Yeah, it's all about educating people. I think that's the biggest roadblock that we're facing right now is we've actually had city officials come up to our roof and say, oh, wow, this is how it looks. I didn't think it was going to be like this. I thought it was going to be very intrusive. But when people do see it, when you talk to them about it, when you educate them about it, the world opens up to you.
Now, talk to me about your system on the roof. There's no holes drilled in your roof.
Not at all.
It's all just sitting there.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people have this misconception that like it's going to be a big construction project. And like you said, there's going to be things sticking off the roof and stuff. You have, like, I'm looking up at your roof right now, that you can't tell that you have solar.
Yeah.
And it seems like it was a fairly straightforward process.
Very straightforward.
I mean, it's weight. It's those cinder blocks that are holding them down.
Yeah, so they create, they do all the wiring ahead of time, and then they lay down the tracking system for the panels and then also the cinder blocks, which fall into place perfectly so they don't move around at all. And now it's secured. I mean, these are up to gale force winds. Nothing's going to happen at all. So we're
protected. Plus you've got a parapet around the whole thing.
Exactly.
Now, a lot of people try and get you in an aha moment, I see, with solar. They're always like, yeah, but what about when it snows? What's going to happen when it snows?
Obviously, I mean, it's not going to produce as much as it does in the summertime. However, the great thing about solar panels is if it snows, that's the first part of your roof that's probably going to be clear because the reflected light from that panel is going to melt that snow faster. Even if there's a couple inches on there or whatever, that's going to be the clearest part quickest. Right. And it's going to start producing.
Right. And you get energy all throughout the winter as well.
Yeah.
There's still sun in the winter. In fact, we have lots of good sun.
Well, even when there's, right now it's overcast, it's drizzling a little bit, we're still producing right now because there's light, there's ambient light that's still filtering through to the solar panels.
Now, how do you let your guests know that you're staying at a place that's solar powered?
We try to just advertise the fact that we have solar with little tent cards that are at the breakfast tables. We have monitors up at the entrance area that kind of show our production. The school I went to actually had that, and I kind of stole that idea from them.
That's
and it was kind of neat because every day I would walk by and just look at for a quick second, oh, the school is producing this much power. And our guests actually do that too right now. They stop and look at the monitor and say, oh, this is kind of neat that you're doing this for us.
What percentage do you think are attracted to stay here if they know that you have solar? Do you have any anecdotal evidence? I know you just got them installed recently.
Yeah, but we just got them installed. I think that the more you advertise it and talk to your consumers about it, the more beneficial it will be for you.
Now, another way to find this hotel is if you're traveling along in your Tesla or on a plug share or in an EV, you've got EV chargers here.
We do.
And so you've got Tesla destination chargers.
Yeah.
And you've got J1772 for, you know, Bolts and Leafs,
yeah.
Right? And so you can stay here. And what's so great about a charger at a hotel is that, say you're a Bolt and it takes a little longer to charge, you're going to be here for a little longer.
Yeah.
So you can wake up in the morning, your car's fully charged, ready to go.
Definitely.
Have you seen a benefit there? Have you seen that people are staying here because you have charging?
Yeah, definitely. It's always fun to kind of walk out there and see. I saw a Model 3 two or three weeks after launch. Like,
oh, wow,
and
early.
I was like, how the heck are they producing Model 3s and they're already out in the Midwest? So it's always interesting to see cars that are plugged in out there. We've had Bolts, Leafs, Teslas, of course.
Did Tesla make it easier or hard to get your destination charger installed?
I think as the program has grown, they're definitely making an emphasis for hotel destination charging and other places. So it was really easy. We actually just reached out to a local electrician and said, can you follow up with Tesla to get this installed? It was actually nothing out of pocket for the hotel to do that. So
wow.
It's a great program.
Hear that? Yeah. I think a lot of businesses are like, well, that's going to be thousands of dollars. Tesla, I think from what I've heard, they can be a little slow sometimes, but they do help fund the program. Yeah. And then you get this kind of part that you don't factor in a lot of times, which is on the Tesla screen when a Tesla driver is driving along. Yeah. There you are, like, where should I stay tonight? Oh, there's a destination charger.
Definitely. It's been interesting over the past year or so where there used to be only one or two destination chargers, and now you look at the screen, at least in Chicago, there's like 30, 40 hotels that have it in different locations. So it's going to be exciting over the next few years just to see that grow.
That's awesome. Yeah. And so you drive a Tesla yourself.
I do.
What have you thought about the evolution of now getting to, you have an S?
Yeah, I'm on my second S. I'm moving into an X pretty soon.
Nice.
So you can tell I'm kind of loyal.
you're kind of hooked, right? What do you think about seeing all these threes pop up?
It's amazing. I love the fact that they're popping up. It's just pushing forward the EV revolution that we're seeing.
Yeah. I mean, I just feel like more and more people are able to get in on this. And when they discover it, they're just like, why didn't I hear about this before?
Exactly.
The biggest question I get a lot of times is, why don't they advertise? And I think, I mean, they're a small company. We forget they're a startup company. But the best form of advertising is just seeing them, bumping into an owner, talking to them.
Exactly. I've had so many people just... initially, when I had my Model S a couple years ago, so many people would just pull me over at a stoplight, just start asking me questions. I mean, you just have to spread the word and tell them about it, because it's a lot of range anxiety that was out there, and you have to tell them, hey, you can go up to 300 miles without a problem. I have never had range anxiety with my Model S's. So it's been interesting when people actually come over to hang out. They'll want to drive in the car. You let them sit in the seat, and then they're like, all right, how can I get one of these?
By the way, where's the dealership? And you're like, there is no dealership. Yeah. Right? We just went into Chicago yesterday. There's superchargers everywhere. Yeah. They're in very convenient spots. We just went to like a garage and boom, there was one. We had lunch, charged up. So Chicago is a great destination for if you're planning a road trip like we're on now. Stay here in Schaumburg with my buddy Pratik.
Yeah.
Charge up your car, get solar powered. I mean, you can't beat that.
Definitely.
Make sure that you visit businesses that are doing the right thing. And this is a business that is. And that's why we came to Chicago to visit, because you don't hear about this every day. You don't hear about a hotel that's making such a gigantic investment in solar energy.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for talking
to
me today.
Thank you
for putting us up and having us. I love your facility. I love your staff.
Definitely.
I highly recommend that you stay here if you're coming to the Chicago area. Thank you so much. Now you know.
The next time you're traveling, check out Pratik's Hotels for your next stay. Friendly staff, excellent rooms and amenities, along with EV charging and solar power. I highly recommend them.
So another cool thing about this hotel is that right behind me are bikes that you can rent. So you can go for a ride around town in a rented bicycle.